Hello kids, welcome to Sunday School. Today we will talk about Ask God, when we ask God in prayer. And we have a worship song by Torrin Wells named When We Pray. When We Pray, that's the title of the song.
People broken, getting down and feeling hopeless. Your earth is gonna always be this way. You'll speak up for the captive, show some love and heal the past. It
binds the ones when we think we'll never go away.
But what if we could be our people on our knees, as one before the King, as we believe? All the world's not changing, when the church starts praying, our world starts to break. Revival rising, I see hope on the horizon, as a generation stepping out of faith. Cause we will be our people on our knees, as one before the King, cause we believe. All the roads are changing, when the church starts praying, the walls come to break.
We love you and praise you, dear God. You are God Almighty, you're our Father, who protects us, who loves us, and we thank you, Father, for this time that you give us to listen your word, to learn your word, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I ask you to prepare everybody's heart, everybody's mind. Holy Spirit, take control of the class, of everything that we want to speak today. In the name of Jesus, we ask you, Lord, to guide me and give me the words to speak, Lord. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. When we pray, it's like we're making a phone call to someone, right? For example, I have this phone, and I'm going to try to make a call. Hi, Mommy. How are you? How you doing? Yes, I'm doing well. Thank you, Mommy. I love you. God bless you. Bye-bye.
When you talk to God, it's like you're talking to someone on the phone, a family member or a friend. You come to Him, trusting Him.
He is there for us. He loves us. He's hearing us. Let's look in your Bible in Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. It says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. Ask. Sometimes when we come to God, we don't ask. We sometimes think that He knows everything, and we just don't say anything to Him. And God said in His Word that we should ask and seek. Seek who? Seek God. Yes, seek His presence in prayer. And we will find. Just try to remember when you lose something in the house. Let's say a toy, and you are looking and looking for the toy everywhere. If you don't look for that toy, you won't find it. It's the same thing. If we don't look for God in prayer, we won't be able to find Him and talk to Him without confidence. It says, knock. just like you knock a door, right? If somebody's there, they open the door for you. It's the same thing. We call God, right? And He's always there. So He will be, yes, ready for us, ready to hear us. There is another verse in the Bible about prayer. In John 16:23, John is in the New Testament, it says, "In that day you will ask nothing of me. Truly, truly, I said to you, whatever you ask of the Father in my name, He will give it to you." And sometimes when we ask God, we forgot to ask. In the name of Jesus. Every time that we should pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, please help me with my test. Amen? No. Lord, please help me with my test. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Just that way. Because the name of Jesus is powerful. That's what we need to use. Jesus' name when we pray. And Mark 11:25 says, "And whenever you stand praying, forgive. If you have anything against anyone, so that your Father also who is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses." If we have anything against someone, maybe we have some bitterness towards a friend or family member, we should forgive that person or ask for forgiveness too, if we need to do it. Matthew 5:44 says, "But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you." Wow. Love your enemies. Is that easy? Of course it's not easy. But with God's help, we will be able to forgive our enemies. And pray. Yes. Pray for those who are not nice to you. Pray for those who maybe talk bad about you. Pray for those people that are bullied to you, maybe, or they hurt you with their words. Pray for those people. You know, when we pray for those people, God changes our hearts. We feel more compassion, we feel more mercy towards them, and love. We pray, everything change in our hearts. Hebrews 11:6 says, "And without faith it is impossible to please Him. For whoever would draw near to God must believe that He exists and that He rewards those who seek Him." Without faith. Why faith is so important? Because if we don't have faith, we don't please God. If we don't believe in Him, in His power, in His amazing love, that He can do anything, if we don't trust Him, He won't be able to do anything for us. We need to trust Him first. Even if your faith is little, like a mustard seed, the Bible said, even with that little faith, we could do a lot. In Matthew 6:6 says, "But when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you." Go into your room and shut that door. Maybe you tell me, "Oh, but I don't have my own room." Maybe you don't have your own room, but that means that you could have a quiet time with God. you and him by yourself. That means that you shouldn't pray with other people? No, doesn't mean that. You could pray with other people, you could pray with your family in mealtime, at night, in the morning, you could do devotions with your family. But God also asks us to pray along with him, to talk to him, in secret. In secret, that means a quiet time with him. Yes, you and God. That's it. And he said that your Father who sees in secret will reward you. There is a reward for those who seek God in prayer. A reward. Yes, a prize, a blessing that he will bring to your life because you are seeking him, because you call to him in prayer. I remember one time I was praying on the phone with 4 to 5 sisters in Christ every day at night. And then I just went to my bed and tried to sleep. And I couldn't sleep. And I tried and I said, but why? I cannot fall asleep. And then I talked to my friend, and my friend told me, after you pray with us, do you pray by yourself? Like you and God alone? And I said, no, I'm not doing that because I already pray with you girls. And she gave me this verse and I start praying. After I pray with them, I pray by myself. Only God and me. And I was able to go to sleep. If you don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior, you have time to accept him in your heart. Repent and confess him as your Lord and Savior. Dear Lord, Father God, I know that I am a sinner and I need you. Please, God, forgive me for all my sins. I don't want to be separated from you. I recognize, God, that you sent your Son Jesus Christ to die on the cross for my sins, so I could be clean from any sin that I did. Thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross for my sins, for resurrected and give me victory over death. I ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you write my name in the book of life and that you help me to fight with all temptations. Help me with your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Amen.
If you did this prayer, the Bible said that it's is rejoicing in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. If you did this prayer, look for a church to congregate and start reading your Bible. Start for the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John.
Ask God to talk to you, to your heart in his word, and he will do it. Remember the prayer is talking to God sincerely. He is there. No matter what you did, you can come to God anytime. You could pray anytime. Talk to him anywhere. Remember that. And trust him. Have faith that he is able to do what you're asking him to do. In his time, remember, our petitions won't be answered in our time. It will be in God's time. Let's pray to finish. Dear Lord, thank you for your word. Thank you, Father, for helping us to talk to you in prayer. for being there for us, always, for hearing us. Thank you, dear God, for all the blessings that you give us. And we ask you, Father, that you do your will in our lives, do your will in our families. Father God, we ask you in the name of Jesus for all those who are in authority, that you give them wisdom, Father, to govern their nation. For all those, Father, who are sick right now, I ask you that you could heal them in the name of Jesus. Just put your hands over them, Lord. Take all pain, all inflammation, all sickness, Lord, because you took all our sicknesses to the cross, Jesus. Holy Spirit, we ask you to help us and remind us to pray, to obey God, to follow him, and to read his word every day. We ask you for those, Lord, who are who lose a loved one because they were sick. In the name of Jesus, please, Lord, give them peace, give them strength. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for guiding us, for helping us, and remind us that we could come anytime to you in prayer. May God bless you and guide you. Don't forget, Jesus loves you so much. Bye-bye.